Guys, good morning to everyone. Today, I'm going to teach you about trigonometry. Before going to our trigonometry, let us discuss what is trigonometry. So, trigonometry, see here, right, means three. Trono means angle. So, metry means measurement. From the definition, we can say the what is the meaning of trigonometry. Trigonometry, it is a branch of mathematics that deals with the three angle measurement. So, I can repeat it again once. Trigonometry, it is a branch of mathematics that deals with the study of three angle measurement. So, definition. The branch of mathematics that trigonometry, it is applicable to right angle triangle. Initially, we studied about the what is trigonometry, then definition of the trigonometry, and then how it is applicable to right angle triangle. Now, to further proceed, we have to know about the right angle triangle. In the previous classes, you may know about the right angle triangle, but I will once again say about the right angle triangle.
So, this is about the right angle triangle. We came to know
was about trigonometric ratios. There are mainly six important trigonometric ratios.
Trigonometric ratio. So I am explaining once again.
What is sin A? That is the angle at sin A is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, that is angle BC by AC is equal to sin A. In other words, sin A is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So, second important trigonometric ratio is cosine. That is complementary to sine is cosine. That is cosine at an angle is equal to A. That is, now we have to define cosine A. That is cosine A will be always equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. It will not change. So here the adjacent side will be AB. And the hypotenuse side is AC. In other words, cosine can be simply called as cos A. So, for any right angle triangle, the value of cos A will be equal to adjacent by hypotenuse side. So, we have to define R1, that is tangent at an angle A is equal to, we have to make sure that we may not confuse about sine, cosine and tangent. So for tangent, we have to cancel hypotenuse and hypotenuse, and they will be opposite by adjacent side. In other words, tangent is simply written as tan A, and tan A can also be written as sine of A by cos of A. You may ask how. So we have defined it as sine A is equal to BC by AC, and cos A will be AB by AC. When we reciprocal it and multiply it, AC and AC will be cancelled. So the third trigonometric ratio will be tangent at an angle A, which is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So in this right angle triangle, the opposite side will be BC and the adjacent side will be AB. So we call it as tangent A as tan A in simple words. So for any right angle triangle, the tan A is equal to opposite by adjacent side. In other ways, tan A is equal to sine of A by cos of A. You may ask how. Let us know. We have defined it as sine A as BC by AC and cos A as AB by AC. If you cross multiply and we cancel it, so you will get it as BC by AB. So another formula is tan A is always equal to sin A by cos A. This is one of the important formula which relates sin, cos and tan. So this is about three. Now I will define the fourth trigonometric ratio, which is called cotangent at an angle A. And so let us define the cotangent. The reciprocal of the tangent will be the cotangent. So therefore, here tan at an angle A is BC by AB, that is opposite by adjacent. If you take reciprocal, then it will be adjacent by opposite. So opposite side will, adjacent side will be AB and opposite side will be BC, and we simply call it as cotangent A as chord A. This is the fourth important trigonometric ratio. So the fifth important trigonometric ratio is secant A. So the reciprocal of the cos A will be secant A, that is hypotenuse by adjacent, that is equal to AC by AB, which is equal to, for secant A we simply call it as sec A, which is always equal to 1 over cos A. So for any right angle triangle, the value of secant A will be equal to hypotenuse by adjacent, that is equal to AC by AB, that is simply called as secant A. In other words, secant A is called 1 over cos A. So the sixth trigonometric ratio will be cosecant A, and it is defined as the reciprocal of sine A will be the cosecant A, that is AC by BC is equal to hypotenuse by opposite side. And in other words, the reciprocal of sine A is also called cosecant A. So in simple words, we call it as cosec A. So I think you may familiar about the six important trigonometric ratio. I will once again explain to you, for any right angle triangle, the trigonometric ratio sine A will be equal to opposite by hypotenuse, that is BC by AC. For any right angle triangle, the cosine will be equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. For the tangent A, the sine will be equal to opposite by adjacent, that is BC by AB. For any right angle triangle, the cotangent, that is cot A, will be equal to reciprocal of, that is adjacent by opposite. For any right angle triangle, secant A, that is sec A, will be equal to hypotenuse by adjacent, that is AC by AB, that is equal to 1 over cos A. And last one, the cosecant A is always equal to hypotenuse by opposite, that is AC by BC. In other words, the reciprocal of sin A will be equal to cosecant A. These are the six important trigonometric ratio that we have to be know before going to solve problems or recording trigonometric ratios.